Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Geo here, and today we're going to be talking about Shake-O. I think I said that right. Shake-O, or Shake-O. Shake-O's manga, Nurse Hitomi's Monster Infirmary, Volume 1. This came out a while ago. I know, if you're watching this channel for the first time, you're thinking, man, this guy reviewing something that came out ages ago. But I got this last year. Thanks to my friend Nelson for gifting me his copy, and I was really excited. One, I like weird, kooky stories, and two, I love manga, so when you mix the two of them together, you get Geo here reading Monster Infirmary Volume 1. So what the heck is this manga about? First and foremost, you need to know something. This is in an alternate reality where the Earth is populated by monster creatures, monster girls, monster dudes, monster people. You know, there are invisible people, there are cyclop ladies, there are vampires, fairy talking beasts, I don't know. There's a lot of weird, random, funny-ass people in this manga. And we follow this high school and the school nurse, Hitomi, and she is a wholesome sweetheart who is a klutz, and yeah, can you see her problem right there? Can you see it? Her huge eye right there? She's a cyclops. What attracted me to this story is the fact that Hitomi, she is more than happy to help you with whatever it is that whatever problem you need, whether it be a physical problem or a psychological one. And throughout the first volume, she gets different people, most of them girls, with different sorts of problems with monster abilities. Like, you have a character that keeps growing. She's a giant girl, and then her best friend keeps shrinking, so she's super tiny. And there's a whole dilemma with that, and they have to deal with some issues. There's another character that has like a serpent tongue, and it's super long, and she's freaking out because she can't control it. So Hitomi is giving her advice, and in this craziness of Monster Infirmary, what we really get is a story about a school nurse doing her utmost best to cheer, motivate, and make these kids realize that they're special regardless of deformities, regardless of their situation. They are special, and she is validating who these characters are and bringing a positiveness to their lives, which I really like. I came in for the wackiness and stayed for the wholesomeness. Let's just say that much. Yeah, the story's a little bit cuckoo, and there is some etchy type humor that doesn't necessarily stick the landing 100% of the time, maybe like 80 to 90% of the time. And yeah, there is some fan service-y bits, but it's mostly played for comedy and not necessarily in a creepy manner. But the interaction between the characters is very sweet and sincere. Through the randomness that Shake-O is doing with the story, there is a sincerity to having a profession like being a nurse and helping out others, because that is one of the best acts that another human being can do. So to have that in the context of monster people, because, you know, school, puberty, kids going through changes, what a perfect metaphor than to represent them as monster creatures. Like, you have the tongue, you can see them here at the back, some of the characters right there. There's an undead girl, there's another one that's, like I said earlier, tiny, there's another one that's invisible, and they all have unique problems that the school nurse, Hitomi, can help them with. So I thought that was really cool, and offered a fresh twist on the whole monster creature, monster person trope. I don't know. It's weird, but I'd like it. The art, for the most part, the art is very simple, but it's nice to look at. The designs for the characters are unique, where a new student comes in and you can easily identify that person and not be confused with the hundreds of other students that are in the school. Obviously, the main focal point, and there are a lot of eye puns in this manga, is Hitomi herself and the way that she deals with her students. With my students, you know what I mean. The school patients. Yeah. And I just noticed, hopefully I don't get flagged for indecency, but that is as risque as it's going to get, but it's played for comedy. It's not played in a pervy sort of way. There aren't a lot of backgrounds because it's a school for the most part. It's an infirmary. And what little backgrounds, see a lot of white spaces, but the character designs make up for it, in my opinion. And there is some actual funny humor. There was a joke with her going to getting new eyeglasses, or an eyeglass, I should say, and then going to the movie theater and not being able to see a 3D movie because you need both lenses. So I thought that was pretty cool. I liked that sort of humor. Pretty slapstick, tongue-in-cheek. So yeah, the story is nothing too complicated, but it's just the right amount of wackiness and wholesomeness where it balances itself out, at least to my enjoyment, and I like it. It's an ongoing series. I don't think it's over yet, and I think I would have to get a whole bunch of volumes from Seven Seas, but I'm in. I like it. Shaco, you did a cool thing. I dig it. Monster Girls, we're here to help. This is rated older teen, 16 and up, and I get it. Yeah, there's some ecchi humor that might not fly with some people, but for the most part, just take it on a comedic route. You'll be fine. There's nothing too risque about this. Also, what the hell? They gave her a 90s comic book waist, the Image era in comics. Okay. I really liked, to end things on a weird note, I liked the... Can I show this? Yeah, I can. I liked the undead girl. I thought that bit was pretty funny. How she can disassemble herself, basically, and she gets stitched up again because she's basically a zombie. So if this is a type of humor, slice of life, comedy thing that you would be interested in, I think you're gonna have a fun time with Nurse Hitomi's Monster Infirmary. This is volume one. Hopefully down the line I'm able to get more volumes and do like a proper review on the series, but for a first impressions, why not? I liked it. Sue me. Have you read this manga? Let me know in the comment section down below. Also, let me know two things. Your favorite comedy manga and your favorite supernatural manga. Because this is sort of a take on both subgenres rolled into one, I think. Thank you everybody for tuning in. You can like, comment, subscribe. Help us, help me get this channel to 2,000 subscribers. That would be amazing. Thank you so much. Hit the notification bell so you know when new videos are coming up. Also, follow me on social media. Just type A Week in Geekdom and I am there for you. All right, I have got to go. I've got more reading, more reviewing, more geeking out over stuff I acquired lately. So I will catch all of you on our next episode.